It's on y'all.
Hey, what's up? It's Shattered Illusions Podcast. I'm here with my man K-Dot.
Yes, sir.
We have
lovely lady.
That's all right.
Okay, lady. Okay. My name is D. This is K-Dot once
what's
again.
What's going on, brother? How you doing, brother D?
I'm good. Hey, we holding it down for my brother, TK. You know, we're going to do this thing. We want to get into a few things with Desiree and talk about some things. So introduce yourself. If you want to plug in your IG, you can. If you want to plug in a friend, black-owned business or yourself, whatever you want to do, you have the mic right now. Let us know.
Desiree.
You got to get up into the mic.
Oh, yeah. My bad. I'm Desiree.
Uh-huh.
IG is at Desi Got Fans.
She got fans.
Oh, okay.
Long story. I don't have no business.
Okay.
I wish I did. But my friends, y'all know the four y'all.
No only fans, right?
No only fans.
Come on, brother.
This close though.
Come on, y'all.
I'm just gonna show my feet.
Oh, hey, respectfully. Respectfully. I like her.
It's some weirdos. They'll do it.
Hey, I'm sure. It's some nasty Negroes out there, boy.
Hey,
it's some nasty nigga. Hey, put your pinky toe in there. Hey. What?
Y'all trying to see my feet? Let me know.
Oh, nah.
Must have put that barbecue sauce on it.
Yeah. So I'm gonna get right into it. Let's talk about it. So let me ask you this: what are the pros and cons of dating this day and age, or not even, or just you know being in a relationship? What are the pros and cons?
Oh God, it's just shit in the dating pool right now, from what I heard.
From what you heard, that's what your friends tell you.
Yeah.
All of them. I don't know. I feel like. They don't make the dudes like they made them. They used to make them.
What does that even mean?
Yeah,
I hear that, but what does that even mean?
It's real. Like back, I'm about to say back in the day, like I knew, but
she hang around a whole lot of older people.
I know, right?
Yeah, she got old.
I just feel like I don't know. Like niggas just used to go the extra mile. Like I see you, I want you, I'ma bag you. And I'm gonna keep it up for a minute.
But so you gonna act like it's an R&B video, but go ahead.
I'm just right. saying. All nowadays, right. It's like I meet you and first date, I'm asking for the cheeks after I pay for the steak, and it's like, whoa, what happened? How do we get here?
Oh, okay. I'm glad you brought that up. How much do you think is the amount a guy should be spending on the first date, or should it just be thoughtful?
I think it should just be thoughtful. Like I'm not. And I get on, she gonna kill me, but I be getting on my friend all the time. Like
you ain't gotta say her name. Put her business out there though.
She know. Okay. You know. I just feel like I do well enough for myself that uh-huh. I don't need no man to buy me no food. Like
uh-huh.
I'm not missing no meal with okay. or without you. So I don't think a price tag should be on the first date. I just feel like it should be thoughtful. Like
okay.
At least ask my interest, take mm-hmm. me, you know, mm-hmm. somewhere in that ballpark. Or something I never did before, but
spontaneous.
Yeah.
So spontaneous. So you talk. You talked about the bad, some of the bad. So mm-hmm. what is some of the good? Like what do you see? Good things that you see from our generation that you still have hope.
I think it is a handful of some good ones out there. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not one of those. Oh, all niggas ain't shit. Like no, I think it's a handful of some that was raised right. That'll actually put in the time to go for what they want. I just feel like. A lot of dudes don't know what they want.
Mm.
But I also feel like a lot of us don't know what we want either. A lot of us women don't know what we want.
Yeah. So
it's like everybody living off Instagram.
So do you think is it mostly on men? Because I hear you blaming the men, but what about the women? Because you have friends, you know the things that they do, the toxic things that they do, the mm-hmm. say, the way they act. If he ain't gonna love me the way I am, he could leave. But why not change? Yeah. Like what about women?
I'm just going out for free food, for a free steak, you know, medium well.
I hate that. And I feel like, I don't know, I just feel like a lot of us have dumbed down our standards to date the dudes that are being produced nowadays, but then we want to hold them higher, like to a higher standard. It's like, no, if your ball was in hell, stay in hell. Like, mm-hmm. you can't expect him to give you more than what you accepted off the beginning. And I don't like that about some of us. Like, we'll just take whatever just because. Mm-hmm. And like some of us, we just don't like being to ourselves. I love being by myself. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't need to be busy, especially with somebody that I can't see nothing with. Like, if it's if I don't see a future or any type of nothing in it, mm-hmm. I'm not going to waste my time.
No, I understand. I'm married. I like my me time. Yeah. I get it. I get it. I like my me time. I, you know, I love her, but I like right. my me time. I'm sure yeah. she like her time, too. So,
absolutely.
I mean, it is, you know, it is what it is. I get that. I understand that.
Yeah. And then it's
you
like,
don't never want to lose yourself. You know what I mean? Exactly. You always still want to love yourself. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And it's a whole bunch of us with kids. Mm-hmm. Nowadays, and it's just like I need my me time.
Yeah. So let me ask you this: what you saying that about kids? Mm-hmm. So how many kids you have?
Two.
Okay. So what ages are they?
I got a 13-year-old and a he'll be 6 in 2 weeks.
Oh wow! Wow. Yeah. Okay. So let me ask you this: Do you think some of the things that you know your friends or other people have done and stuff? Like you kind of still want to do or you've missed out on some things. Do you feel that way at all?
No.
Okay.
I live my life. Like, okay. It's to the point where, because I got a good support system. So
that's
I
good.
Take the kids to my grandmothers or my mm-hmm. mothers and I be gone. And then they father there too. Like yeah. my husband there too. Uh-huh. So it's like, I ain't missing out on nothing.
And that's, the reason I asked you that, because I think a lot of women do experience that where, you know, they don't have that support. Mm-hmm. Everybody doesn't have that support system. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like my daughter right now at my parents, she's spending the night. You know, a lot of people can't do that, you know. Mm-hmm. So I'm thankful for that. And you know, so I definitely understand that.
Oh, so I was going back to what you were saying with your friends. They was basically saying, like, I guess, you know, like the dating now is just trash. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, what kind of dudes are they looking for out here? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't think that.
Do you not know? Or you don't just want to say that.
No, I really don't know, because my friend in particular, she says she want one thing, but what she doing and how she moving, it'll line up with something else. Like for instance, the dude that she's dating now, he lied. Like they only knew each other for 4 days. And she put the shit together like, yo, man, he was on a vacation with somebody in a whole different state.
Okay.
You said they only knew each other for 4 days?
They knew each other for 4 days. They was talking for 4 days.
And what did he lie about?
Where he was and who he was with.
Okay.
Oh, so he was out the country with somebody else.
He was out with another joint.
It was his woman. Don't call her another joint. That's his woman. That's their man, woman.
Maybe. Ooh.
That might be his wife.
Might be. But he's so dumb, like, dude's so dumb that like he would put shit on his story and it was the girl's birthday. So he tagged the girl. It was made a little happy birthday post mm-hmm. as if she was like his friend. So she went to the girl page and saw the same shit in her story, like where they were.
Did she go to her as a woman?
No. No.
Okay,
I was
good.
Not rocking with
good,
that because I'm
good,
like,
good.
That's her nigga. Like, okay. You can't step to her.
So, how do you feel about that? When I'm coming to you as a woman, that whole thing.
Don't come to me and shit. Like, don't do that. I fight.
Oh, Lord.
I would rather... because I just don't know what I would get from that. Like, you telling me, then what I'm going to do, go ask him, he just going to deny it. Like, I'm the type, I'm going to find out. Mm. Same way my homegirl found out about her dude. Well, excuse me, not her dude, but the dude that she talking to or whatever.
4 days, why did she invest so much into that?
That's what the fuck I was trying. That's what I was trying.
I mean, like, was this over social media or was they, like, in person?
They
like,
met in person.
They met in person.
They met in person. Okay. He was FaceTiming her every day. Oh,
for 4 days. But 4 days, though.
Four days.
Why so much investment into to do an investigation?
I have no idea. And he was on this vacation for, like, another, like, 3-4 days. So, technically, they was talking, like, over a week. But still. So then, okay. Like, when she found out he lied... She like came at him like, I know you lied, you did this, you did that. He owned up to it surprisingly, but then she still went out on a date with him.
Listen, I'm gonna say, I don't know why you're surprised.
Yeah,
I don't know why you're surprised. You know, you all women, you all thrive off that. You all thrive off stuff like that. Yeah, and it's like he said, it's a thrill. It's something that you all are interested in. I don't even know why you act surprised.
Yeah.
And then this is something, you know, because I think women get to a place where they think they could change a man's mind.
I do see that.
So you think you can change him? Oh, and they think the competition's is on. That's what's really going on. Oh, okay. He got a woman. They went on vacation. But watch this. Right. And that's what I think that's what goes on.
Yep. Let the games begin.
I can't. You got him. You win.
So you never been in a situation like that?
Not knowingly, not willingly. And when I found out, I was like,
I say this all the time. I think everyone was a side at one point in time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Everyone was somebody's side at one point in time.
Sneaky link.
Option, some type of option.
Agreed.
At one point in time, you were someone's other option at some point in time. Knowingly or not knowingly, you were someone else's option. Like, let me deal with them today, type thing.
Yeah.
So, you know, it happens to the best.
Mm-hmm.
I just think as we get older, we got to be better at, you know, got to be better at seeing that or not playing those games with people.
Yeah.
Because her doing that, I'm going to tell you now, I'm going to be honest. He done lost respect for her.
Yeah.
So he just sees her as a sexual thing now. He's not leaving his wound.
Have you told her?
Yeah, I tell her all the time because she knew. So she just got out of a relationship. And so I try to put her on to game.
She on the market. Yeah. That's what it is. So yeah, it's like she don't care. Like, she not looking for nothing serious or nothing like that. So she just having fun for now.
She says she is. But you move a different way. And I told her, I was like, you're going to have to go through like
wishful thinking. She wants something real. You know what I mean? But right now,
she knows it's not real. Like I said, she's in there for the thrill. That's definitely a thrill. Okay. So I want to talk about something. We all going to say what it is. It's, it might be funny. It might be kind of messed up. But what is the pettiest reasoning? We're going to go around the table. I'm going to start with you, Desiree. What's the pettiest reason you stop talking with someone? That you were dealing with?
Pettiest?
Like petty, like dang, why'd you stop dealing with them because of that?
All right. Don't judge me.
I'm not
judging. This is a judge-free zone, okay? I want to tell all the viewers, this is a judge-free zone. When you come on the show.
So I got this thing where like I can't take noises and I hated the way he chewed.
Noises.
Oh my god!
Okay.
Like,
so he was.
And I can just.
I ain't gonna say nothing.
I can hit a swallowing, and I just was like, "Oh shit!"
Why was he eating food so sexual?
Right. That's what, like, was he looking at you? Like, was he like? Was he getting intimate? Like, looking you in the eye? Like, like I'm gonna eat this steak. Like,
the worst part is, it was ice cream. This nigga's chewing ice cream.
He like his ice cream chunky.
I don't know who he was. You foul. You foul boy. You nasty.
You know what she talking about, too.
You nasty.
You know what she talking about.
Eating your ice cream. Why? Who choose ice cream? You probably choose soup, too, boy.
Oh, my God. I was like, let that shit
melt. I can't trust that man.
You know, people get old and they just chew for no reason? That's going to be him. Chew for no reason. What are you chewing on, Grandma? Your tongue? Tongue got cuts on there, everything. Chewing on that tongue. With them gums. Hey.
That is weird.
Yeah, hey,
that's wild, bro.
That's crazy. I don't think that's petty. I don't think that's petty.
I think that is too. You know,
like, so you might gotta dig a little deeper. So what's your pettiest reason? I would ask again. Don't try to don't do that.
I gotta think.
Yeah, okay.
I gotta think. Hold on, go.
So that's number one. Yeah.
That's number one. You go. Okay. Let's hear something petty while you stop dealing with somebody.
Man. hey. I don't know if it was one of them days, but she had a little head.
Oh, Lord.
And, you know, I'm out of bed, so, you know, I'm just looking at, like, how the line is going. I'm thinking, like, oh, damn, like, she could really grow a beard like mine. So I was looking at, and it's the first date, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm looking at her, you know, we having a good time, and I was like, oh, like okay, and then
Asian lady. Oh, she had hair on her chest.
Yeah, on her chest.
She had taco meat.
She had two pieces of hair right here. I'm like, you come on. Like, if you gonna have that out, come on.
I'm be honest like, with you, bro. So much out I'm here. Be honest, bro. I hope you ended it right then and there because
oh, that was it.
Downstairs, it probably was a bad that was situation.
I was done deal. And I'm gonna tell you something. We didn't even get to the restaurant. We didn't even get there.
Why?
We got in the parking lot. She met me up there. I met her up there. We about to wait in line. And I was like, man, I made up an excuse. I'm like, yeah, I'm not waiting up here for no 45 minutes. Let's go to Jasper's real quick across the street. You know, so, you know, if y'all don't know Jasper's, that's basically like the Black Ruth Chris in the PG County area. If y'all don't know what it is, unfortunately. So, but everybody in that jump. But yeah, so we went across, she about to go across. She's like, yeah, I'll meet you across the street to Jasper's. I was like, yeah, sure. So when she drove over there, oh, I drove home.
Oh, yo, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yo, man.
Yeah. I got up out of there. I had to get up out of there.
You was a bam. That's messed up.
I got up in there, you know. So I'm very detailed. Like, I'm a Virgo, so I pay attention to detail very well.
Oh, you a Virgo.
You know what I'm saying? Cool,
brother.
I'm a detailed dude. What?
I'm not into all that worst. Sign stuff.
You know, stop playing. Stuff. How are we the worst?
That's the next
topic. Oh, Lord.
Oh, my God. I found my petty one. Right.
You go ahead. What's your go ahead. I'm a Cancer. Okay, your birthday right. Coming up.
Yes.
Okay, so. Okay.
Oh man, this speaking of Jasper's.
Ooh.
Oh God. Yeah, so this dude came up to me, apparently knew me from middle school. I don't know how I still look the same, but whatever. So we exchanged numbers.
That's a good thing.
Yes. And he's texting me, he's like, oh, what you like to eat? Blah blah blah. I'm like, why niggas always feel like we want something to eat? Like,
y'all do.
I'm gonna die.
Nah, look. I'm gonna tell you something. I'm gonna tell you why women like to eat. This how I gauge how mad my wife is at me. I say, hey, you want something to eat? If she tell me no, I know I'm in a bad place in life. If she tell me yes, I got a chance. Yeah. I got a fighting chance. If she tell me yes, that's all I'm gonna say. Y'all love to eat.
Facts.
We do, but still.
Better not come in that house with nothing. You better not come out with your own meal and then sit down at the table.
No.
I'm telling you.
So he was like, you like seafood? I'm like, yeah. It's like you eat scallops, and he spells scallops with an O. He got blocked.
Okay. No. That's a little petty. It could have been a typo. Sorry to that brother.
You saw that red line.
Sorry to that brother.
She said the red line, though.
He had an iPhone?
Yes.
He kept going with it. You right. You wrong.
Hold up. Hold on, wrong. Man. I mean, he was trying to. But look, though, he might have been nervous. He was trying to impress you. You know what I mean? Like, I would give a brother a chance. I mean, I get it. I get what you're saying. You like, man, how you on the space scallops? I understand. But he might have been nervous, like, you know, trying to get to know you. And
yeah.
I gave him a chance.
I don't even know what
that
spells. Oh,
I'm dead.
Oh, that brother.
That's petty. That's too petty.
I hope you figure out how to spell scholars, brother.
I hope.
Listen, don't judge me, you all, because I was young. I was young. I'm not even going to tell my age when I did this. But this girl, she's very beautiful. Look really good. Her back was connected to her legs. Her back, when I seen that her back was connected to her legs, it confused me. I never seen anyone such with no butt at all. I didn't know what to do. I was confused at the time. I didn't know. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I didn't know. I said, hold up. What is going on? Where's your butt?
You the butt of all jokes.
Whatever Michael Jackson said, your butt about his mouth. He took her butt. I don't know, but I'm gonna just say this: that was petty. I stopped talking. She was really nice, a nice girl. Sorry to you. You're never gonna know that, but you might because you say, "Dang,
that's why." I hope you're doing squats, sis.
Damn squat. It's gonna help her thighs, her hamstring. What? There ain't nothing gonna happen. But you know what? But I'm not gonna lie. That was really petty. But I have grown from that. I'm a married man. I don't do that with women anymore. look at them in that way or judge women for that. But that was a bad time.
Oh yeah,
that was a bad time. I shouldn't have done
that. Older, bro. Older,
I shouldn't.
You would not have married your wife if she ain't had a butt.
You not lying. I like all that. I like all that.
Something to hold on to.
I like all that.
You say forever?
I need all that.
I need all that.
I need everything. I need the package. I need all of it.
Buy the package. Huh?
That's fine. I mean, that's another conversation. I don't know how I feel about it. I mean, I feel like people could do what they want, but at the end of the day, that's not something I want. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I want something real. Yeah.
Cause I feel like even if you feel like you got your flaws, I love you for who you are. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? I ain't. Cause at the end of the day, how you gonna look when you turn 70?
Exactly.
Cause we haven't had enough proof on how that goes.
Yeah, baby, show me that birthmark. You know what I'm saying? I like that birthmark. Come on now.
So sexy.
You know what I'm saying? I like that little birthmark right here.
I don't know. So let me ask you this. How, because we talked about the pros and cons of everything and how relationships go and everything. I think something that has become like more prevalent. People are going to therapy with their relationship and themselves. How important do you think that is in this realm of dating and just being with someone, your overall mental health? How important is that?
I think it's like top two.
I agree.
Cause
so what's one?
Jesus.
Hey, okay.
You gotta know Jesus. Hey, I ain't saying you gotta be in church every Sunday.
You better stop it before I put you on the key.
I'm just saying you gotta know the Lord name.
Okay. Okay.
We all said this, but you know, it is what it is. I think mental health definitely is top two, number two, because
very important.
Shit's just crazy. Mm-hmm. And then when you start losing yourself, you can't be there for nobody else.
Nope.
And I think Black people just got this stigma, like, especially men. I don't need to talk to nobody.
But that's difficult. I just want to say this. That's difficult sometimes when you say Black men, because people, when you're vulnerable as a man emotionally, people think you're weak. And not even just other men, it's women that look at you weak. Mm-hmm. Like, I've seen many men that are vulnerable when women, and I seen when they go through something or something, but you was crying about such and such, or you was telling me this, or telling me, start putting their business out there. Mm-hmm. So it's like, why be vulnerable?
The one you need to be with.
Yeah, that's true. But I'm just saying stuff that has happened over time when men did choose to be vulnerable, and you know, a lot of times men do have bottled up emotions because they don't want to be vulnerable, because if they're vulnerable, people use it as ammo sometimes.
Agree. However, we just get stuck in this box. Like, that's, hearing that is the same thing as saying, oh, that's just who I am. At some point you gotta change. Like, because you can't take what a past, like, I understand everybody got a past, and some people, you know, that shit's curry with you.
Yeah,
but
can't let it get in front of your future.
Yeah. And it's like when you move on to something else, if you being vulnerable is on my list, but you scared to do that because your last joint was like, oh, you such a pussy. You're not checking my boxes. And I ain't saying you got to check all 10 of my boxes, but if that's one of the main ones, you got to do it or it's not going to work.
So I feel like women are more vulnerable to get their heart broken so many times. That's the reason why women get their heart broken so many times, and men are just like, they have their one heartbreak or maybe even two, but women have 40 heartbreaks sometimes before you get to them.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying. You all are suckers for love. So most much, definitely. I feel like.
And I got a question to add on to that. So
go ahead. What's your thought?
Ooh, that hurt.
I'm just serious. Yeah, you're hopeless romantic. Most women. A lot of you are fake. I don't need no man. That's because no man ever did anything for you. So you don't. That's why you don't need any man. Because when you get that thing where he says your tire flat, I guarantee you, my wife say her tire flat. I went to her job, changed both her tires, drove it back, and guess what? You know, she was thankful for it and everything else like that. But when you do stuff like that for women, men haven't done those little things for you. I think the little things are so important.
That's what puts you outside the box. You know what I'm saying? Like waking up, making breakfast in the morning for your woman. You know, that's
French toast. My shit to the French toast. Filling it up. But I just feel like I hear what you say, D. But if you look at like, oh, I went through 40 heartbreaks and now I'm just a hopeless romantic and like I'm just, oh my God, I'm so vulnerable. Man might look at you and be like, no, I don't like that. Like that's weak. That might be weak to a man. But then if I turn around and I'm like, no, I went through 40 heartbreaks and fuck it, I'm cold.
I'm gonna tell you, most men aren't gonna say most men aren't gonna say that's weak. You want me to tell you why? Because most men prey on things like that.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
So they're not gonna look. They're not gonna weak. But it's not that you. It is the vulnerable stage. That's what they say, and that's why I tell women all the time. When you get with a man, even when men get with women, I tell them, don't tell the person everything that you want or everything that you want in them, because they're going to show you the things that you want. Because they're going to, what a person usually does when you say, I want this, I want a man to be this, or I want a woman to be this, they're going to act like that person that they are not.
He already got the playbook, so hey, okay, she want flowers, she like this, she like that, all right.
It's a thing that my dad has said when I was a young boy and everything else like that. So it was a scorpion and a frog. The scorpion asked the frog, said, hey, I need to get to the other side of the pond. He said, nah, I'm not doing that, because if I do that, all you're going to do is sting me and kill me. I said, all right. So he said, you know what? I'll do it. So the frog took him over to the other side. They got to the other side. The scorpion got off his back. He stung him. He said, I thought you said you weren't going to sting me. He said, it's in my nature. So it's a lot of things that times people do things that are in their nature. Fuck. So you got to let people be people sometimes and let them show you who they are. Yeah. So that's what I tell people all the time. Like, don't give people the whole rundown of this hurt me, this is what, and this is what I like. They're going to show you. Yeah. I mean, and once you get to a point, you can instruct people on things that you like. I get it. But when you first start dating someone, they're going to bring their best self.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
But then that turns into a lot of dudes like, oh, you so cold. Oh, you got this wall up. You got that. No, like, for me, it takes me a minute to trust somebody. Excuse me.
I'm
and that's not just because, oh, the shit that I've been through. That's who I am. And I'm not saying that makes it right.
No.
But it takes me a minute. And yeah, like when you first meet me, I'm gonna be guarded, and that's just gonna be what it is. You're not gonna figure me out for a long time. And even when you think you figure me out, you don't know me.
Okay. So let me ask you this. Do you ever you said all these things, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever look inward like, okay, this is what I need to fix about myself?
Yes. Yes.
You sure?
I swear to God.
Okay.
I swear. So
you gotta get up in that mic.
Wait, oh my bad. So with my husband, I've been with him since I was what, 16? No, I was 14. So just going on 16 years. And over time I realized, like, damn, I'm like my mother in many ways. Then I was like, all right, let me get out of that. Then I'm like, damn, this don't feel like me. Well, this don't feel like the best me. So then I did the therapy, and I just kept trying to figure out what it was. It was me. Mm-hmm. Like, and I had to dig a little deeper.
Mm-hmm.
And so over time, I start changing. But then it's always some times where I revert back, or I let something take me back, and I'm like, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, look at yourself. So I do a lot of self-reflecting.
Okay.
A whole lot.
Okay.
A whole lot.
So do you try to coach your friends and ask them, like, hey, you might gotta look at yourself? Or when you know that there's type of way and they start talking about a dude, do you tell them about themselves? Because a lot of women don't tell their friends about themselves.
I tell all them bitches about themselves. Oh, Lord. Straight up. I am that friend.
Okay.
And a lot of times they stop talking to me just because I don't tell them what they want to hear.
Are they all single? I wanted to ask you that.
So two of them are single. One is about to get next year.
Okay.
And one has been in a long-term situation.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm sure the one that's working on getting married, are y'all the closest? Are y'all the ones that hang out the most? No. The single one is?
Yeah.
No, you missed it. You're not paying attention.
Yeah, I got
she don't, it down. We will talk about that later. But she's going to hang out with the single ones, because she said she like to have a good time. She here for a good time. The single one's going to give her a good time. The one that's married, she's gonna stay up under her husband. Which women, I'm gonna just tell you, gentlemen, now, women switch up once you get married. They gonna switch up on you. I'm telling you.
I didn't.
You didn't.
No.
I'm gonna tell the truth. She's not gonna tell the truth.
I
women switch up on you. I'm not saying they get hard or anything like that, or if some might, but just from my experience in talking to other men, for example, I'll give you a few examples. First and foremost, sex. I feel like
he's not getting this.
It's come to Jesus moment. Nah, it's just different because when you throw a kid in the equation, work schedule, everything else, it's just different. More responsibilities and everything else. Women just switch up on you. You know what I'm saying? So it's just a whole different. It's a whole different thing once you are married. It's not the same. So you saying you stayed the same throughout? From dating to marriage?
In certain aspects.
Oh, okay. Now the truth is coming.
And all that shit. Like,
the truth's coming out.
We can't get it popping all the time. We got motherfucking rugrats running around.
Yeah, I get that. But I think people look. I think even both sides, sometimes you lack in trying to be what you were doing during the dating phase and stuff like that. You lack at it because it's like, oh, that person's dead. I think sometimes it's not the man.
That's the man.
That's not the man. So I think both people take each other for granted. Because
I'm not married. I'm not a married. You know, I'm not married by any means. So can y'all? I got a question for both of y'all. So how in that aspect, brother. Like, once you get married, you know, you got the ring. You know, that's like, you know, the, y'all trophy. I'm gonna just say, you know. So after you get that, you know, y'all got that honeymoon phase and everything like that. So how do you continue to keep that? How you continue to keep that energy going? I mean, I'm sure it's not all the time, but you know.
Yeah. excuse me.
You got four more clears.
My bad. No, my bad. I ain't got COVID. Go I got my test.
Oh, okay.
On the phone. But
go ahead.
I think you just gotta know the person that you with. Like, you gotta know. Damn, I just had this conversation. You gotta know what that person likes and like what gets them to like in that mood, especially when you talk about sex. Like, you gotta know how to get them there. Okay. Because a lot of times, shit, I'm not there. Like, I got other shit that I'm focused on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not as easy as it was. Like, shit, when I was fucking 15, 16, I was just wilding out. Like, it's not that easy. So you gotta know how to get me there. Like, I need to see some flowers. Walk through the door. I need to see.
Why flowers?
It's just a little shit. Because what else you gonna give me?
You gonna take care of them flowers? You gonna let them flowers die?
No, you gonna take care of them?
See?
Wow! Wow!
They're just there for me to look at.
Wow!
For them to be pretty.
Well, I guess we both just gonna be looking at these flowers because I mean, I'm not cutting this. I'm not doing
now.
I'm not doing none of that.
I got OCD, so I'll arrange them.
I don't even think I got a vase in my house. I'm be honest.
This
man. Listen. I might not got no face.
Come on.
I might put it in this red cup.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
I'm just saying.
Blocked.
Yeah, I don't get that far. I'm sorry.
Some of the flowers come with a face, man. It's the little shit. But that's what, like, I noticed the little shit. Like, go get your hair cut. Don't walk around here looking like a bum. Go, like, clean up a room. Help me fold the clothes. Help.
Okay, I get that.
Shit like that, like, little stuff. Okay, especially
I get
when
that.
You're married. So, like,
understand.
When I say I haven't changed, take notes. When I say I haven't changed, it's in certain aspects. Like, I hang with the single girls because I like to have fun, but I am the fun.
Okay.
I'm the party. Like,
everybody think they're the party.
I swear to God. Okay. I am the fun, and it's not disrespectful to like the point where somebody gonna tell my husband like, yo, she wilding, and he gonna slide in my shit like, fucking wrong with you? Like, it's never disrespectful to that point, but it's me. And when I come home, I'm drunk at 3 o'clock in the morning. He gonna be like, did you crash the car? I'm gonna say no, and that's gonna be the end of it.
So he just okay? He just cool with you just being out all night, all type of hours?
Yeah,
you know.
It's just.
Put the camera on me.
Okay.
How often do you come in the house at 3 a.m?
It depends on the month.
Okay. It depends on the month. Okay. A good month when you done went out 2-3 times. How many times are you coming home at 3 a.m.?
All three.
It's after 3 o'clock sometimes.
Maybe once.
What do you need to do after 3 o'clock?
That's what I'm saying.
Huh? I'm sorry, I'm in husband mode.
I go to my girl's house to sober up. Just because I live so damn far. I swear on everything. Like,
well, your girl better have a room for you because that's where you live right now. That's your new residence.
Take care, beloved.
But I check in.
Hey, it's gonna be some checks and balances because what?
I check in.
Okay, I mean, hey, you know, hey,
what's look, checking in? Like,
I check into like, hotels.
Like, give me a scenario. What's your checking in?
Like, what's checking in? What does that even mean?
What is that?
I'm good.
Like, you tell
me, Angels, or I'm at T's.
Okay,
and he just said, okay,
he don't even.
Well, listen, that three, that's crazy. I ain't gonna say you can't say, I'm gonna just tell you this. You can't say it couldn't be me because there's, I don't look at other people's relationships and stuff like that. I don't really get too much into that because of the simple fact of this. You don't know the ins and outs. Cause if you fine with him coming in after three?
If I know where he at.
Stop the cap.
Thank
I swear
you.
To God, I would rather.
Okay.
I swear, I would rather know that you sitting your drunk ass somewhere.
Somewhere
that I know where you at. I know who you with. So, I trust you with. I would rather you stay there than you come home and you blow me.
So who asks the more questions? Like when in those situations, is it you or him? Like if he out, are you? See, here's the thing. This is what I talk about all the time.
And I know
my wife thinks she's slick. So when she go out, I don't be hitting her phone. She with her friends, she have fun. With me, when I'm out, she'll call me on FaceTime and say your daughter want to say goodnight. I ain't doing that. I'm only over my man's house. You know what I'm saying? But you know, I know the tricks of the trade. So I'm gonna ask you this and be honest with me.
Mm-hmm.
Who do you mess with him while he's out more so than him messing with you while you out?
So I'll say this.
Okay. She about that.
No. I swear. I told y'all I was going to be transparent.
Okay.
If I do hit him, it's because I don't feel like cooking. And I'm like, what time you coming? Because I want you to bring me home something to eat. That'd be the only time I had. I swear on her.
So you come home earlier.
But he don't.
You try to put a burden of responsibility on him to get you food.
So when he see that text, he like, oh shoot.
How far are you? I'm getting hungry.
I didn't see the text.
But the game's still on, boo. The game's still on. Right. I can't come home right now. You want me Uber eat you?
And I'd be like, yeah, send me the money. And that's it. He won't even hit me when I'm out. It'd be the next day. He be throwing a little shade and shit. And I'd just be like, I'm still drunk. I don't really feel like talking about that. Had a good time.
You don't feel like talking.
No.
See,
and he don't have social media, so like his little bitch ass friends be sending him.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
y'all know who y'all are.
Oh, hey, shout out to you, brother. Good job.
The disrespect.
Hold on. Bring it back. Good job, brothers. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah, and I'm gonna pray for you, bro. You know. Dang, the disrespect.
Oh my God.
Listen.
Like, well, like, so what you got against his friends?
I don't
have nothing against them.
You called them BAs.
Cuz why are you sending my shit? If he got questions, he gonna ask me, I'm gonna tell him.
That's true. I'm out of my business.
Yeah,
you know? I'm out of my business.
Yeah.
But I'm not gonna lie. If it was one of my brothers in here, and I'm saying while I'm not sending, I'm not. If I seen the woman or something like that, they, you know, if they was with a woman and stuff, and that's what happened, and I seen something, I'm telling my man.
Oh yeah, that's low.
I'm saying if they I seen them wilding or doing something crazy,
yeah.
If they out, I ain't gonna, hey, why she out? That's I'm out of my business at that point. But if I'm out and I see her up on another dude or something like that in her face and the kissing or something, or she rubbing his face or something like that. Hey, I'm gonna be honest because they know me. A lot of people don't know this because the way I carry myself, I'm gonna go up to her. I'm like, hey, what you doing? Like, I'm a brother. This is gonna say what you doing.
That's only right.
Well, what you doing though? I'm not taking no pictures. I'm not taking no pictures. I'm gonna say, hey, what you doing? I'm like, hey, brother, how you doing? Who are you?
Amen. Mm-hmm. I told you I don't be wild enough. So his friends will send like the pictures that I post on IG of myself.
Oh, and
that's petty. That man see me walk out the house.
I'm out of my business. I'm out of my business.
What the fuck? He stole what I had on. He don't need to see me in the hookah bar. For what?
Yeah, I can't remember.
Why are you sending that? That's petty.
Okay, so let me ask you this. We went through all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So when you are who is someone that you look towards to talk to that's going to be honest with you, not going to soothe your ear, not going to tell you something that you want to hear, but stuff that you need to hear? Is it a friend, is it a family member that be like, hey, nah, you was dead wrong. You shouldn't have did that.
It's my spicy ass grandmother.
Thank you, thank you, Grammy. Thank you for telling about us. Her name's Sheila. She made the greens. Sheila made the greens.
Bernice from Georgetown.
Oh, Bernice. Oh, Niecy. They call her Niecy.
We call her Burn now.
Burn. Oh, well, she did. She done. Burn. She done. Burn. Yeah. Can she cook? Can she cook?
Oh, yeah.
Mm, okay. Okay. Okay.
Shout out.
DC's
finest. Okay. Hold on. What she be cooking? Saying. What should we cook?
She be cooking all the shit. The green beans. Shit. I ain't never seen nobody make potato salad from scratch. Fucking scratch. Love my grandma. She do the greens.
Her potato salad good that though. Because people be saying that my grandmother cook. My mother could cook.
I'ma bring some.
I'm a person. I'm a potato salad connoisseur, like I'm a food connoisseur, period. Cause they here tell you when I tell them something good, I'm like, hey bro, you gotta try this. Or something not good, I'm gonna say it's not good. Cause I come from a long history of a family that could cook.
Man, I'm telling you.
Some of that rubbed off on me too,
man.
I'm telling you.
These people's gonna throw down. I ain't gonna lie. These people's gonna throw down. I'm talking about I took a 2-hour nap. Over his people house at the itis after church. Oh man,
yeah, that was crazy.
I loosened up the tie, everything. I was laid out.
I can't.
Yeah, you get baptized over there. Down.
I'm telling you,
my mother can't cook shit.
Oh come on, mom. Come on, mom. Don't throw mom under the bus.
You forgot the recipes. What's going on? She got no recipes.
They loosen the recipes.
Loosen recipes. It's going on. That's crazy.
Was cooking for forever. She ain't teaching
them
shit.
All right, so you think women should cook? Do you think like that's a responsibility of a woman?
I don't think it's a responsibility, but I just think as a woman, it should just be something.
Like, you know? Like, are you the cook at your house?
Yeah. I mean, he'll cook too, but he ain't doing the shit I'm doing. He doing tacos and spaghetti and basic shit, brown the meat.
Oh, man.
You know how y'all do.
Hey, what no, you mean, y'all? What y'all, you mean, y'all? I cook. I'm actually the cook.
I'm not him.
Yeah. I'm the cook at my house. Cook. I don't know what you told me. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah,
it's funny because, like, in my family, like, real talk, the men cook more than the women.
The reason I know how to cook is me being greedy growing up. Nah, for real. I used to stay in the kitchen while my mom cooked, wait for the food to be done. I ain't know I was learning how to cook.
I will say his folks, they, I don't know. I don't like their food either, but.
Ooh, don't you got to do that old meal to them. Oops. Sorry to y'all. Mm-hmm. God, dang.
Your man used to eat salmon out the can and shit. And then, oh, we silent? Hello? Hello?
Yeah, I just had to get back. Okay. I had to get back in in motion.
Don't do that to them.
Oh. I'm mind my business. I'm mind my business.
Nah, my stomach just.
Yeah.
Stomach kind of sugar.
Fucking eggplant. Like, why are we eating that? That's disgusting.
What?
So, yeah, no.
Okay.
Yeah, I had to pull out the book. Like, come on, that's what we doing.
You pulled out the Bible on them. You start pulling out verses. That's what when you say the book, I'm thinking you talking about the word.
The cookbook.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are you doing with the eggplant? That's what I want.
They eat that shit. Like they slap cheese on top of it and like Mariners. Oh my god.
Listen.
Y'all ain't gotta be quiet.
No, because that was. I didn't see that coming. I'm gonna be honest. I didn't see that coming.
Is that from his like background, like where you know, like where he's from, you know, something like that?
That was just what they did. They'll season their shit.
Oh like, Lord.
Yeah. 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 So like when I tell I introduce this man to life, like,
I ain't gonna lie. Ooh. I ain't gonna lie. I think a lot of women I dealt with, they didn't even really like me like that. They was just like my mama cooking. they ain't even like me like that.
Grow up.
I'm being real. I don't care though. Cause I ain't like them like that either.
Clearly. Shut up.
Clearly. Clearly.
Okay.
Okay.
It's not a trophy.
Clearly. Nah. I'm saying clear. Hey, listen. Hey, I'm just saying.
But nah, I don't think it's all responsibility. I just think as a woman, it's something you should know how to do and be willing to do.
Get back in the kitchen.
Yep. Yep.
Real talk. Shout out. Hey, 2022 women. Come on. Let's get back in this kitchen, man. Let's get back in the mix because a lot of these women ain't cooking. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on these days, D, but
the thoughts of K-Dot is not the thoughts of D. I don't care if you can't. Listen, I love you. I love my wife. I love my wife. I do not want her to go in the kitchen. I love you, babe. Hey. But I do not want you to go nowhere near the kitchen. I'm going to do the cooking. I'm okay with it.
I get it, though. You gotta cook with love, too.
I'm being real. I'm being real. She know it's fine. Listen, this the problem.
You don't sound fine.
I am.
Boy got a little high.
Nah, because it's cool.
I don't mind cooking.
No. I'm fine with it. Listen. This is what I'm gonna say. I'm being real. I think this is how I feel. I think that like it should be okay that we are good at different things. She might be better at one thing. Like I talked about before, like she might be better at keeping the bills in line. That, you know, I might be better cooking. I might be better at fixing things around the house. It's your strengths. That's why when people say you gotta bring 50-50, you can't bring 50-50. You gotta bring 100-100 because I might be lacking one day. You might be lacking. Mm-hmm. That's the whole thing about marriage. Like that's the thing. Like so if that's not her strength, that's not her strength. You know, I play around with it, but like that might not be her strength. Some areas that I'm not so strong in, she's stronger in. So I mean, that's just what it is.
You gonna teach her?
I don't mind if she's willing to learn. Listen, she likes me waiting on me. You know, me waiting on her. Like I fix her, I make her plate, and I'll give it to her. She likes stuff like that.
I do too. After I cook it, like bring that shit to me. But I'm saying cooking. You don't want to teach her?
It's not that I want to teach her. If she's willing to learn, she can. Cook,
have
cook.
You offered?
Listen, no, yes, I have. Let me tell you, because my family, where I come from, I don't do any measuring. I can't tell you, I'll put this amount in there, put that amount.
Tablespoons, I don't know none of that.
I feel, you know what I'm saying? I'm from North Carolina. You know what I'm saying? I'm just feeling how to cook. You know what I'm saying? That's how I do. So I can't tell her. So she'd be like, how much should I put in here? Or how much? I don't know. I feel it. She be thinking I'll be playing. Like I be cooking to turn the music on. I just be cooking.
Tastes a little bit here.
I mean, tell me how you know what I'm saying? It's a lot of eye rolling going on.
Mm-hmm.
Unnecessary eye rolling. It's crazy.
I hear what you're saying.
Uh-huh.
I hear what you're saying.
Okay.
But coming from my situation, I was strong in cooking and he was stronger in the finances.
Okay.
But when I want to dive into the shit and I understand it, I need you to help me understand it. He felt like, I got it. So you don't need to understand it. It's like, nah, but I do because this is my money too. So help me understand. But for him, he's an accountant.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, I just put this in a computer and it's like no.
Yeah, it's probably like a second language. It's probably like a second language for him. He do it all day, every day.
Yeah, but no. Help me understand.
Yeah, layman's.
That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. That's what I'm saying. If she asked me, that's what I'm just saying. Like what can I do? Like you just said you don't measure anything.
But you said
she got three more left.
Shut
y'all.
Up. You looked at that camera and said, I don't want you in the kitchen.
No, I said she don't have to be it. I'm saying she ain't gotta be in there. Like that's not what. You don't gotta be there. Like it's fine. Like I say, it's other things that she does very well. Like she's very intelligent. Right? You know what I'm saying?
See,
she's very intelligent.
Look, I don't load the dishwasher because I don't.
I'm not good at loading the dishwasher. She's excellent at loading the dishwasher. Yeah, you are excellent dishwasher loader. That's what she is.
I don't do that trash.
I suck at it. She's like, why is only 5 things in here? Because I don't know how to load it. I be trying. I swear I be trying. I don't. So sometimes she just tell me she's.
I didn't grow up with a dishwasher, so see, that's what I'm learning down the line. You feel me? I get it though.
Yeah, my grandmother ain't use her shit either.
I didn't.
My mom uses to store dishes.
Oh.
She just store dishes.
We paper plate. We paper plate everything too.
Yeah, she just put dishes in there. Okay. That was another cabinet in my house.
Okay.
At one point in time, we paper plates, cups. I'm not used to that. My mom would go to Sam's Club and get plates to cover this table.
So I got some questions for you, love. So what's your ideal of a man? You know, like as far as like masculine, like, you know, provider. Like, what's your ideal man? Like, definitely, what do you look for?
Definitely a provider. Like, I don't believe in that whole you got to make more than me, blah, blah, blah. I mean, you got to be in my tax bracket, but.
So would you be okay with a man not making as much as you?
I would be. Just as long as you able to still at least do 50-50. Like, well, 60-40, but if we able to go 50-50, that's fine. But that's because I got kids.
Okay.
So, like, I definitely need you to yeah.
Okay.
Be somewhat up there. I definitely need a sense of security. I hate when people be like, oh, you got daddy issues. I don't have no fucking daddy issues. I didn't grow up with my father, but I know I definitely don't want a nigga like him.
Okay.
But definitely need that sense of security just because, like, coming from seeing, like, domestic violence and all that shit, like, I kill you. I don't never want to, you know, be put in that situation. And then, wow, that's a good-ass question. I don't know. It's going to sound cliche, but I just need to be loved right. Like the way that I ask to be loved. Don't love me the way you want to love me.
What's that? Like, what's your ideal love? Like,
love languages.
You know, like, yeah, what's your love languages?
Yeah. I am a words of affirmation.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Like, I don't need you to compliment me every time, but.
You like poetry?
No.
Okay, I'm just saying.
I don't like the
like a dude shit. That's good with them words. You never know.
But like,
you said, well, cheesy.
Sometimes, you know, it could be.
What's going on? I mean, no.
New Year's, right? I'm sitting in. And I'm like, oh, I'm about to go out. Let me try on these dresses. My husband like, you should wear that one. I'm like, I don't really want to wear that one. I don't think it's fitting for the venue. So I throw on a black dress. He like, you got 12 black dresses in your closet. I'm like, I don't care.
Why do this y'all do that?
Because the fuck, they all look different.
Yeah, so. But you ask us our opinion, but y'all still already made up your mind.
They're going to go opposite. They're going opposite.
Yeah.
Look, it didn't matter. I was bad in both of them, so it didn't fucking matter. And so instead of just hearing, you look good, it was, I would have wore the other one. All right.
Do you want the truth all or right. a lie? He's telling the truth.
You told me the shit once. I heard you the first time. You ain't got to say that shit 4 times. God. Then you want to know, motherfucker. Motherfucker had a conversation with his friend about me choosing the other dress over the one he liked. What the fuck wrong with you?
Wait, let's get me this straight. So he was having a conversation with a friend about what dress you're about to put on?
His friend was just like, dog, compliment her. Like, just tell her.
No, I feel that,
when
brother.
I tell you, I went out.
I feel you, brother.
And
don't ask me with the pick. You going to pick the opposite. I feel
him. I picked it. God damn it. And you should have just been like, all right, cool. You look good in it. Because every nigga at the venue that I went to said it. So,
but did they want to love you, though, like him? No.
Mm-hmm.
First of all. He's still working on loving me the way I asked him to.
Oh, you didn't say your other. You didn't say your other.
So you wanted to see if you still got it.
It's acts of service.
I know I still got it.
It's acts of service, isn't it?
Okay. It's not. It's not. It's okay. It's touch.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I don't know. I'm weird. Like, I want to rub my feet on you and shit. Don't throw my feet off. And then I'm anemic. So
that's
really
not weird. They're not crusty. That's cool.
They not. They real pretty.
Hey, listen. Only fans on the way.
You know what?
No,
but no, I just, like, why he looking at me like that?
I'm mind my business. Go ahead.
I need you to do it the way that I ask you to do it, not the way you want to.
I get it. I mean, everybody want to be loved the way they want to be loved. Yeah. You know,
listen to me.
But do you make it easy to listen to you?
At times.
Okay.
I told you I was going to be honest. At times.
What's at times? What's at times look like? Because
when I'm fed the fuck up.
But I'm saying like, that's why I asked you the N-word question. Like, when do you be like, you know what? I just did too much. Do you be like that? Do you apologize? Like, I just did too much. Do you apologize?
Now, I just recently started apologizing. In the last year or so, I have started apologizing. But now, like I told you, I do a lot of self-reflection. So I don't feel like I do too much now. Like, it takes me a minute to just, yeah. But a lot of people look at that like, I don't really care. Which, I mean, at times I don't. Like, I'm all right.
Cool. No, I get that because I'm not one to get angry anymore, mm-hmm. Like I used to. Mm-hmm. So when I do get angry, it's pretty bad. Mm-hmm. So I try not to even go there.
Mm-hmm.
I try to avoid a lot of that because I'm not even gonna say, but like I really try to avoid it because it's just like I hate going that place.
Yeah,
I hate going that place.
Definitely.
Because it's not even, I'm a happy person. I laugh a lot. I play a lot. Mm-hmm. So me going to that place is never a good thing.
Never in between.
And I don't like letting nobody feel like they got that power. Like,
yeah,
you can just take me back.
But I think everyone knows or has that person that just can truly just piss them off. Mm-hmm. Like, everyone has that person.
Buttons. Oh,
like, and they know your buttons.
They know your buttons.
They know, like, if I say this or if I do this, they're going. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but everybody has that person. And we have that person that we do that to when we feel like it.
Mm-hmm.
So you're a button pusher, too. I could tell.
Yeah.
You're a button pusher.
I could see that.
You're a button pusher. Yeah.
That's hard.
But I am going to say this. I thank you for joining us tonight. I appreciate you for being transparent. I think that was shady, but I do appreciate you for coming, joining us. My name's D.
This K-Dye.
And
Desiree.
This is Shattered Illusion Podcast. I do want to just quickly say this. We, like I said, once again, we holding it down for my man, TK.
Yes, sir.
I just want, before we end this show, I want to say rest in peace to Mom. We love you, and we're going to do this for you, and we're going to go up for this.
No question. Rocking always. We gone. We out.
Shattered Illusions.
Will I take him to the creek? Yeah.
Look, we get your friends with